offer modeling the back. First, what we want to do, select these edges right here. Shoot it just like that. Move that up. Now, select this edge and this one. Actually, just this one for now. And move it in like that. Like so. Now, if you look at reference, you can see that there's this thing going right here. So, what we're going to do is just select this. Select vertex and target weld. Target weld it to this. Now just move it into position. Okay, now select this edge. Loop. Click view align. And this is a new tool I just learned, which we want to do is select this edge, click ring. Now I'll click connect. This box right here, by connect. Now I never tried this, let's see what this will do. Let's go with 3. Seems pretty equal with 3. Now it's added here. One. Alright, once we have that, we're gonna loop, but deselect everything except this. Now we're gonna shoot to the end. Now look at the reference. We have this thing to do, so. There we go. And now, loop it. Now, as we can see, it has like a sharp line going right there. Let's not worry about this rear stoplight yet. Brake light stop. No, not stoplight, brake light. Now what we're gonna do is loop. Let's see if this. Oh no no. Here, ring, connect. Okay, now we're gonna extrude it all the way down. Well, most of the way. We're gonna need to hide some of this stuff. Alright, right there. Right here. Ring it, connect it, and let's add 3. Reason why I did 3 is not because to get it more even, but when we do the rear lights, I like to make the glass and then do the rear lights right from the glass. Alright, now what we're gonna do is we're not gonna keep it like this because I don't like chamfering, well, final chamfers until we have everything we need modeled. So we're gonna get these. this is just to see how it will look. This is nothing final. Looks like it will look very nice. Alright, now undo. Save it. Now it's time to model this. Select the cut tool. And basically cut out this shape. And now, let's see here, ring, then connect it by one. Like that. Let's hope this will work without any bumps or anything like that. Huh. All right. Could do is add these two. Save here. What we need to worry about most is so it doesn't cause bumps. Save it as a new file. We're gonna need to go back and tweak, as you can see, like right here. It's a bit too sharp, I guess. Let's see if we go without that one for now. Open that file. We're gonna need to work with all those polygons. Deattach it. Hide that. Now what we're gonna do is this. Shoot it in. Loop. That's what kind of edges it has. Let's go with a 1 and then 0.8. Actually, 0.4. We need to fix this. Now after we camp right here, Should look more proper. Yeah, we'll worry about the top later on. Alright, save it now. Alright, now let's go back and fix these bumps. Okay. Let's see here. It's good. All right, now we gotta do is take these things apart. Take the edge like that. You have to buy one open. Right now, we have a keyhole right here. Align it. Alright, that still works. Okay. And this is what we're gonna do. You'll see why in a second. Alright, delete that. Now watch, we take this one, the one we just made. Come to editable poly, over symmetry. Now, what we're gonna do is, shoot it just a little. V align. Now we're going to do this, convert to double poly, and delete half of it. And attach it back to the main body of the car. I just find it a lot easier to work with things when they're already complete. Like, it's easier to scale it down if it's already a circle. And right now, all we're going to do is just extrude it in. I have no idea what's going on over here. Interesting. Alright, not a problem. What we're gonna do is shoot it back like 3 times. I wonder what is going on over here. View align it. Now you want to check the front, see if we screwed anything up by accident. And no, everything looks fine. Alright, now we're gonna make the little rubbery thing around. And that's the easy part. Just like border. Camphor. By one. And deattach this. Hide that rubbery thing for now. Do the border again. Now what we're going to do is this watch, select the last one, unhide all, move it out, pretty far so we can get selection on it. Detach it. Now we hide the front glass. Select double click flip. Now we move it back in like this much. Now we create a border, not a border, but we create an inside polygon. Yeah, for about one. Unhide all. Take off turbo smooth. Select the rub rating. Loop. Now attach these three to each other. Now we select the trunk, attach this to it. Now we save it as a new file. Just see if it'll be bad or good. You could just camp for it right now. You can see it looks pretty good, or will. Yeah. Now undo and save it. And now, for like the emblem and these emblems, that will be part of a new tutorial. It's going to be, well, it's part of this, like you get it and everything. It's just called details, because that's when I make these things, like the window wipers, the stuff like that, the little things. Well, that's mostly it. Window wipers, these emblems, front emblem, and that's pretty much it.